What up? It's your boy T-Bear, Henry Ash, and Tavis Feels Friday. We got finished with the appetizer, with the trailer, and a special deleted scene. Now we're going to do this side dish. And since one, my lovely wife is making some Asian dish, pho. And two, this past week, last weekend, I treat my wife to, we all had to get together at a K-pot. But this is Japanese, but still. We're going to get down to some Asian dish this week for my side dish for Films Friday. And we're going to return to the anime kill count. Well, I had this plan before I said all that. But I'm going to check out this. I had this in my list before. I thought maybe I should do that. My kill count has some time to do some anime kill count. This is Perfect Blue. It looks cool. Looks kind of cool. It's curious. So I don't think I may have heard of it one time. I never actually fully watched it. So it's good to see this one right here. It came out in 1998. You know, 90s anime, especially the serious ones, was the shit. The new ones were in 2002, but the 90s was always the shit right there. So without further ado, let's check this out. From Shore, Kodoi.
Yoso, I'm Shiri, and this is the Anime Kill Count, where we count the kills strictly in anime. The anime we're covering for today is a classic animation film called Perfect Blue, released in the winter of 1998. Perfect Blue is a Japanese animated psychological thriller film directed by Satoshi Kon and written by Sadayuki Murai. This anime is based on the novel Perfect Blue, Metamorphosis. This anime was produced by my all-time favorite anime studio called Madhouse. Perfect Blue is about Mima. She was a former member of a Japanese idol group named Cham. She left the group to pursue an acting career. She is accompanied by her longtime manager, whom also is her friend, named Rumi. Mima's acting career was a disaster. She was sexually harassed in the line of work, stalked by a creepy-looking dude who seems to listen to every breath you take, and someone was trying to take over her identity. This anime is disturbing as hell. It's a complete mindfuck type of an anime, but it's worth to watch. This video will contain spoilers, so heads up and enjoy this kill count.
Person that stole their identity, or this the girl getting, or is this the actress girl getting revenge? For those who watch this anime, comment down below. Cause shit, woohoo! I ain't expect to be this crazy. See, that's why I told you, the '90s series anime was a shit though. Woo! Nah, it's that. No, it's not her. Cause that's her. About to get the best of that little stalker guy. And the music, of course, is crazy as hell. It's dope. Oh, he's a crazy look. He's a... Oh, gee, really sharp. Oh! Damn. Oh, now he's there. Oh, the girl. Oh, the stalker chick. Those.
The review of the kills is where we give context about a certain kill, which appears to be vague for some viewers. I'm only giving context to the last two kills in the anime. The creepy-looking dude in Tadokoro. Later on, when Mima receives a phone call, she picks up, but no one's on the other line to answer. It turns out Tadokoro, along with creepy-ass looking dude, was dead with both their eyes gouged out. There isn't much info about their demise, but what I do know is Rumi killed them both. Rumi, you know, the chubby chick who was Mami's manager, was also the one trying to steal Mami's identity. There's a total of 4 kills in the Perfect Blue. All of the kills were men. With a runtime of 81 minutes, the anime left us a kill on average about every 20.25 minutes. I'll give the Kinkatana the most satisfying kill in the movie, to Murano. This dude is the photographer of Mima, and I think he's abusing Mima by taking photos of her butt naked. Someone knocked on his door. Apparently, he ordered pizza. When he was about to pay for the food, the pizza delivery guy takes out an ice pick and stabs Murano on the eye. He's able to run away and attempts to grab the phone, but the pizza delivery dude stabs his hand. The identity of the delivery pizza dude was revealed and it turns out it was Mima. She finishes Murano by stabbing him continuously to death. The shabby kunai goes to the first dude to die in the movie. He heard distant music and it made him anxious. The elevator door opens and inside is a speaker. The anime cuts and the next time we see the dude, he was dead inside the elevator, with both his eyes gouged out. This anime is stressful and horrifying. A good horror, if I must say. The story focuses on stalking, sexual harassment, and identity theft. The animation also contributed to why this anime is terrifying and eerie. The characters are well written. I'll give this anime an A for Asa.
Yeah, definitely is a good anime.
That's it for today's anime kill-count.
Shit, I might fuck around want to watch this myself. Underdog. Looks interesting. I'm going to check that out. It might be the next one or the course party. Let me know. I might fuck around and do a poll for these, man, for real. Other than that, if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe my YouTube channel. Unless you got some Shiroi Kudo kill-counts you want me to react to as well, too, comment down below. Anyway, it's your boy T-Bro signing off. One love.